एंड वेलकम इन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल मेटलर्जिकल फैक्ट्स। सो दिस इज पार्ट थ्री ऑफ दिस वीडियो सीरीज दैट इज गेट मेटलर्जी सॉल्यूशन एंड आंसर की ऑफ फॉर गेट 2021। ओके सो द क्वेश्चन इज व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग व्हिच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट अलॉयड विद आयरन इज अ फेराइट स्टेबलाइजर। ओके सो फेराइट स्टेबलाइजर ऑल बीसीसी एक्सेप्शंस विद दैट डायमंड क्यूबिक सिलिकॉन। ओके सो डायमंड क्यूबिक सिलिकॉन इज ऑल्सो फेराइट स्टेबलाइजर। सो हियर यू कैन फाइंड दैट दिस निकिल हैविंग स्ट्रक्चर एफ सी सी कार्बन इज ऑल्सो द इंटरस्टीशियल एटम। ओके सो दिस इज नॉट फेराइट दिस इज ऑस्टेनाइट दिस इज ऑल्सो ऑस्टेनाइट कार्बन एंड नाइट्रोजन इज इंटरस्टीशियल एटम एंड दिस आर ऑस्टेनाइट स्टेबलाइजर मैगनीज इज एफ सी सी सो दिस इज ऑल्सो। ओके सो नाउ सिलिकॉन इज लेफ्ट सो दिस सिलिकॉन हैविंग द डायमंड क्यूबिक बट दिस इज फेराइट स्टेबलाइजर। ओके सो दिस सी पार्ट इज करेक्ट हियर for this question. The next question is, in the x-ray diffraction pattern of FCC crystal, the first reflection occurs at the Bragg's angle theta is equals to the 30 degree. Okay, so this theta one is 30 degrees. So they are asking the Bragg's angle in degrees for the second reflection. So this is for first reflection for FCC. So h square plus k square plus l square is 3, you know, by the extension rule. Okay, and they are asking for theta 2 and for the second reflection. Okay, so second reflection means h square plus k square plus l square is equals to 4. So here the point is that they are not changing the order of reflection, means n is constant, means n is equals to 1 for every situation. Okay, so what is the formula we are having? Sin theta is equals to 2d sin theta is equals to n lambda. This is Bragg's law, you know. Okay, so what is the if you will expand more, that is a by under root of h square plus k square plus l square, and this is sin theta l lambda. So everything is constant, that is lattice parameter, n is constant, lambda is constant, but sin theta and h square plus k square l square value is varying. Okay, so what will be the relation between this sin theta and h square plus k square? That is directly proportional, that is h square plus k square plus l square. Okay, so so from here you can get like that. Okay, so I will do here. So sin theta is equals to sin theta 1 is equals to under root of h square plus k square plus l square. This is for first reflection. And what about the sin theta 2? That is also h square plus k square plus l square. And you know the relation, that is h square plus k square plus l square is first reflection is 3 and for second reflection that is 4. Okay, so sin theta 1 you know that is 30, that is 30. Okay, and sin theta 2 you need to find h square plus k square plus l square for first reflection, that is root 3, that is root 4 for second. Okay, so sin theta 2 from here you will get like that 0.5 into 2 by root 3, that will be equals to 0.5773. okay, so from here you will take inverse values, so sin theta is equals to 0.577 35, but they are asking that Bragg's angle in degrees. Okay, so theta will be equals to sine inverse 0.577. you can put these values in virtual calculator and you can find the theta, that is 35 degree. Okay, so round off to the decimal one places, so you can find 35 point something, that is 35.23 degrees. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is 35.23. so this type of questions we practice many times in our practice session. Okay, so this is easy question and 35.23 is correct answer. So this is from the matrix question and they are asking for eigenvalues. Okay, so eigenvalues you can find by the one of the properties that that all the diagonal elements, the sum of the diagonal elements will be equal to the sum of the eigenvalues. Okay, so from here you can eliminate the options. Okay, so whatever the options have 1 plus 1 plus 1 means that will be equals to 3, that is the correct answer. Okay, so this is also one way of doing this eigenvalue if they have given the options. Okay, so this is the sort trick. Okay, so 0 1 2 3, this is the sum of these 0 1 2 3 is 3, 0 2 2 2 2 that is 4, 1 1 2 that is 4, that is 4. Okay, so 3 is correct answer here, that is A option. So 0 1 2 is the eigenvalues of this matrix, that is given. Okay, so 0 1 2 means A option is correct here. This question is basically from material balance question and this is easy one. So a blast furnace uses hematite ore with 80% Fe2O3 and 20% gang material. So I already told you, whenever you are doing this type of questions, please try to maintain a chart, try to make a flow sheet, process flow. Okay, so you have ore that contains 80% of Fe2O3 and the rest 20% is gang material. Okay, and the next thing is that they are saying it uses 600 kg coke per ton of hot metal, means 600 kg coke is used for 1 ton of production of 1 ton of steel, means 1000 kg production for 1000 kg steel production we need to put 600 kg of coke, okay, and in this coke contains 85% of carbon and 15% of ash. Okay, so the next thing is that this steel contains 95.5% Fe and rest 4.5% is carbon. So they are given some assumptions here. Okay, that is 1 ton is equals to 1000 kg like that, and they are asking assume that the gang material of the ore and ash content of the coke from slag while Fe2O3 in the ore is consumed in making hot metal. Okay, so in this question they give the straightforward that the gang material of the ore and ash content of the coke from slag. Okay, so these two, that is gang material and this ash content from coke forms slag. Okay, so this is basically easy. Okay, and they are asking weight of iron ore and the slag produced. So how to find the weight of iron ore? You need to find the weight of iron ore. We don't know weight of iron ore, so assume W naught. So W naught contains 80% of Fe2O3, and I already told you this Fe2O3 produces 2 Fe in one reaction. So 160, 11, 12. So for one, this is 1 by 111 by 160. So 80 by 100 into 112 by 160 is equals to, we are balancing Fe. So then right side is steel in liquid form. So 100 kg into, in this steel we have 95.5% of iron. So you can find W naught from here, that will be equals to 1705.35 kgs. Okay, so now they are asking for the weight of slag. So how to find the weight of slag? Weight of slag is basically the weight of gang material which is going into the slag, and the ash content from the coke. So W of ash in coke, so these two will make the slag content. Okay, so the W slag is equals to 1705.35. how to find this weight of gang material? We know in this ore 20% of gang. Now we know the weight of ore. Okay, that is 1705.35. so we can find 20% of this, so that you can find the weight of this gang material plus 600 multiplied by 15 by 100. That is, this coke contains 15% of carbon, that is S, 15% of S that will go into the slag. Okay, so this is 341 plus 90, that will be equals to 431 kgs. Okay, so this is the correct way of doing this question. So fourth part is correct, that is weight of ore is equals to 1705 and weight of slag is equals to 431 kgs. Okay, so this is correct answer. The next question is, which one of the following is hydrometallurgical operation? So the first part is zone refining, roasting, leaching, smelting. So this smelting and roasting is basically pyrometallurgy part, and zone refining is also a part for refining purpose of semiconductors. Okay, while this leaching is the term that is utilized in hydrometallurgy operation. In our practice series, I always told you that leaching, solvent extraction, solvent ion exchange, cementation, gaseous reduction, these all are the part of hydrometallurgical operations. Okay, so here 3 is correct answer, that is leaching. The next question is matching type of questions. Again, you need to write like that PQ, RS, and you need to find the odd one or the common one, whichever you know, to eliminate the options. I did not take in the option here because you may get confused. That's why I will tell you the code and I will tell you one by one. Okay, so dye penetrant test is basically based on the principle of capillary action. Okay, so in different form they already asked this question in previous year. Okay, in form of MCQs. So dye penetrant test you can match through the capillary action, that is P is equals to 2, and the next one is radiography, that is based on the absorption process, basically that is x-ray absorption. Okay, so Q you can match by 1. Next is eddy current test, and the last one is the ultrasonic inspection. So eddy current is something related to the electromagnetic induction. Okay, so you can match this eddy current by 4, and the next last one is ultrasonic inspection. Ultrasonic inspection basically works on the principle of elastic wave reflection. Okay, so RS you can match by 3. So code is 2143, that is correct. Okay, so one by one I already told you. Okay, so here in options you will get confused for eddy current test and ultrasonic inspection, but don't get confused. This eddy current test is basically based on the principle of electromagnetic induction, and this ultrasonic inspection is based on the elastic wave reflection.